Tuesday, March 16th. Edinburgh, Scotland. The Balmoral Hotel.
Morning. How are you? Okay, I'll come by and collect you then. Okay, see you in a minute. Bye.
A phone call from publicist Fiona Marsh signals the beginning of another day for Monica Lewinsky.
Hi.
Hi.
It is the ninth day and the seventh city of a book signing tour through the United Kingdom. In the next 12 hours, she'll add two more cities and hundreds of miles to her odyssey. She says she would prefer not to be here at all. But with legal bills between $1 and $1.5 million, the selling of her new book, Monica's Story, is now Monica's job.
What time does the signing start?
Besides Marsh, other members of the M team, as they like to call themselves, include Monica's chauffeur, Sue Turner, and her head of security, Paul Oten. They've only been together a week, but already they've become a familiar foursome.
And then we can get in the car, and concierge are going to help us because we've got to do a UE again.
Oh, right.
You know, one of those UEs.
Now, do we know where the freeway is this morning?
She passes the 2-hour drive to Newcastle, England in a variety of ways.
Hi. How are you?
Thanking a journalist for a favorable story.
I wanted to tell you I really enjoyed the article. It was really sweet. So I hope you didn't get too much flack for it.
Contemplating future interviews.
Bye. It's that guy from People Magazine.
Okay, I still need to talk to Richard, so.
Okay.
I don't trust anybody in the media.
No.
It isn't the only change since Ken Starr came into her life.
Okay, I'll leave you an address. I don't email anymore, since they were all published for the world to read.
Even the passing scenery can bring up reminders of the past and a sometimes wicked sense of humor.
We'll have to see if we find the witches from Macbeth.
Yes. Hopefully we've left them behind.
Yeah, Linda Tripp's in the States.
Crossing into the north of England, Monica gets an impromptu lesson on the regional accent.
What else? What are their greetings in terms of hello and goodbye?
Are you all right, pet?
What?
Are you all right, pet?
Are you all
right, pet? No, that sounds too much like Welsh. No, they say, are you all right, pet? How's it gone? Boy, that looks canny.
How's it gone?
No, how's it gannin?
How's it gannin?
Gannin, that's it, ah, you've got it.
How's it gannin?
How's it gannin?
How's it gannin?
And then if it's a lass, if it's a female, you put pet on the end. How's it gunning, pet?
How's it gunning, pet?
That's it! She's got it, lad!
But as they get closer to their destination, the mood begins to change. Monica's security team is alerted that a known sex offender with an obsession for her has been spotted at the next event. They decide not to tell her.
We've got about 600 people down there at the minute. The whole area is chock-a-block. What we might need to do is to go into a holding area for a couple of minutes just until the police get the area clear for us to get in.
All right.
Don't worry, don't worry. Smile and sign.
Shoulder.
Smile and sign.
That's right. S&S.
At the bookstore, the crowd is growing. Many have been waiting for hours.
Oh, my.
Put lights on. You're going into there. Jesus.
Oh my goodness.
I'll just push down here.
It is ironic that Monica's arrivals and departures now resemble the movements of a head of state.
Hey, hi, how are you?
I'm fine, thanks.
With Monica safely inside the bookstore, the scene outside takes on a carnival atmosphere.
She's a fast signer, apparently, so...
Is she a fast signer?
Yeah.
She's fast at quite a few things, isn't it?
Newcastle to a virtual standstill earlier today.
Now make sure you send him a copy.
It is only after the cameras leave that the signing begins in earnest, at a rate of 500 books an hour.
Pardon? What do you think of the Northeast?
It's great so far.
Good.
It's a little too cold, though.
Yeah.
Yes. Aren't I a pet?
A pet, yes.
The interaction is warm and friendly.
How's it gunning, pet? No, you're a man, right?
But while most people are supportive of Monica, her security team is always prepared for the worst, as this young man is about to find out.
Sam, hello for me.
It turns out he was reaching for nothing more sinister than a magazine to be autographed.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Sorry.
The rest of the event goes without incident.
That queue.
Good God.
Have you seen it?
God. It's a lot of people.
That's a lot of books.
The signing is over, and still the crowd hangs on, hoping for just one thing, a glimpse. They'll have just 5 seconds in which to get it. In a carefully orchestrated security plan, Monica leaves the building and enters a car.
I'm doing it, mate. Come now.
Thanks, bye.
I've got the signing.
Monica's entourage is behind schedule and back on the road.
Really?
On the way to her next book signing, Monica Lewinsky gets some good news.
Oh, terrific. Oh, well, congratulations. We'll have to celebrate tonight. Oh, gosh, that's great. Okay, bye.
The good news is that, we're number one in England.
Are we?
Yep.
Her tell-all book, written by Princess Diana's biographer, Andrew Morton, has just become a bestseller on 2 continents.
Number one in the US and number one in the UK.
Yeah. Wow. Woo. All those people reading about my embarrassing life.
The news seems to lighten the atmosphere, revealing a side of Monica Lewinsky that few have seen.
Oh, good. Back to my favorite song. Finally, we got some decent music in here.
Oh, absolutely.
Lauryn Hill.
Led Zeppelin, Pink Floyd.
Fiona's gonna lip sync for us, right? You're just too good to be true. I need you, baby.
So I'm gonna take it seriously after this. I need you, baby.
At times, this 25-year-old can seem wise beyond her years. But she can also seem like a kid in a back seat during a long trip.
How much longer?
Another half hour.
Meanwhile, at her destination in Leeds, thousands have converged on the city center to greet America's latest export.
Oh my gosh.
Back in the car, she prepares to run yet another gauntlet.
Hi, Neil. We're just coming in around the back now. You should see us, yeah?
Cheers. Oh, here are people running.
No matter how many times she's been through this,
yeah, we're gonna do a hot one here.
She still appears uncomfortable and anxious.
Keep going, sir. Keep going. Stop.
Monica!
Inside, Monica is reunited with a familiar face, her biographer, Andrew Morton.
Yes, I know. I don't know if the crowd can handle it, Andrew.
I know.
I mean, you're just...
You know, they're agog with indifference.
Too big of a superstar.
When I walked in through the door, the security man stopped me. He said, who are you?
Morton repeatedly jokes that they are like an old married couple.
You could go first.
No, you're up to you.
They argue all the time and don't have sex.
Author before subject.
Yeah.
Andrew likes to write these novels because he has so much time, so few books to sign.
It's amazing, isn't it? Come back to me.
You should have worn one of the ties I gave you. Little brat.
Well, no, they said it didn't go with this.
It's going to be a fun night.
Okay, let's go.
When I'm ready, not I'm you. Okay, and I'm in this chair?
Yep.
Okay.
She takes her seat alone for another obligatory photo op.
I hate this.
After Morton joins her, the signing begins. With someone to share the spotlight, Monica seems to be having fun.
Hi.
I'm a big fan. Thank
you. Of mine or his? We're having a contest.
Right.
Oh, no.
Just signed that book.
Shut up,
Morton. All she does is give me a hard time, this girl.
So here we are, 9 hours after we started with Monica this morning, in the middle of her second marathon signing. We've covered 202 miles, she's worn out 2 pens, and signed about 1,400 books.
28 success from.
During a break, Fiona Marsh and Monica read the latest press reports about their trip.
Are you my flunky, my secretary, or my friend?
I'm your spokeswoman.
Oh, uh-huh.
The bookstore cashiers are complaining they can't keep up.
What can I say? I'm a troublemaker.
Dun, 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 dun. After a quick change of clothes, they're off to the next event.
Okay, all right.
After dinner?
No. We're not going to.
Where I am, who I am.
It's going to be really quick because there is a hell of a crowd.
Okay.
Jump straight in, Andrew, you fall straight in.
Another hectic departure.
Hi.
8 o'clock and Monica's day is not over. Her next stop is an English fish and chip shop for a photo opportunity. The only problem is, she doesn't like fish.
I like fish, chips, and mushy peas, please. What do you want, Mom?
And I just want chips and mushy peas, please.
Right.
By 8:30, they're off on foot to a local pub for another photo opportunity set up for British television.
Is it this pub?
Yeah.
For her, even a short walk can be a big production.
Cheers. Here's to being number one. Cheers.
The pub visit lasts less than 10 minutes, just long enough for a taste of beer. Finally, the day ends at a hotel in Leeds. By almost any measure, it's been an extraordinary adventure. But for Monica Lewinsky, this was just another day.